Hey guys, welcome back. Today we are going to discuss about how exactly you can connect Microsoft SQL Server with any of the JetBrains IDs. So you can use these tutorials to connect SQL Server with any of the JetBrains IDs. Say for example like Rider or PyCharm or WebStorm, DataGrip. You can use this tutorial to connect with any of these ones. So before going to the IDs first, we have to configure something in the SQL Server configuration. So let's do that first. Go to your Windows menu and search for SQL. And you will see something named SQL Server 2019 Configuration Manager. So the application name might be different for different versions of SQL Server. Right now I have installed Microsoft SQL Server 2019. That's why it's names like SQL Server 2019 Configurations. So click on OK. Click yes. Okay. In this one, go to SQL Server Network Configuration. Expand this one and click on the protocols for SQL Server. And select the TCP bar IP protocol options. Click on this and right click here and go to properties. Make sure you have enabled this one, otherwise it's not going to work. And click on apply. So what it's saying is you need to restart the server in order to get any effects of this. So click on OK here. And before closing this, go to this IP address section and note down the TCP port. And make sure if you have anything running on the same port number, you just change it here. So right now I am leaving it as with the default configurations. So let's click OK here and go to the SQL Server Services here and select the first process and click on right click here and select the restart option. So this will stop the service and start it again. Right now it's starting it again. Okay, it's actually restarted. So now let's go to the ID options. So in order for this demonstration, I'm using PyCharm for this. So let's open PyCharm here. Okay, right now it has some boilerplate code. So open. Let's close everything and use this database option. I usually don't like this here. Let's move it to the left side. Okay, so if you are not seeing this option, you can go to files and settings. From here you can go to this plugins, and if you are not installed this one, you can search it in the marketplace and you can install it here. So I already have it installed. So the plugin name is database tools and SQL. If you are not seeing this option here, you can come here in marketplace and you can search this one. Let's click OK here and click on this database tool, and right now we are going to add the SQL connection to this database tool. So let's click on this plus button and select the data source, and here select the Microsoft SQL Server. Click here and it will open a dialog where we can configure a few things. I would like to call this as local localhost MS SQL, and the port will be 1433 that you have seen in the previous SQL configuration tool, and the instance name will be MS SQL Server, I believe. So you can get this name from SQL Configuration Manager, and you can see the name protocols for you know, the name after this four is the instance name. You can select that. So the for my case it is MS SQL Server. I believe I typed it correctly. Yeah, that's it. So for that, okay, so that's it. And select the authentication method you prefer. I usually prefer Windows credentials because I don't have to trick off I don't have to keep track of my username and password. So I'm using Windows credentials here. And make sure you have selected the Microsoft server, JTDS server, I mean JTDS driver for this, otherwise it's not going to work. Okay, so right now it's complaining me that the driver is missing. Let's download that real quickly. Okay, that's it with the configuration. Well, let's test this connection. Okay, so the connection is good, succeed. So we were successfully able to connect from a PyCharm with our MS SQL server. Let's click on apply here and press OK. So it should bring me the database. Okay, so here I can see my database. So let's see what's in my SQL server. Okay, right now it's refreshing. Let's wait for a few seconds. Okay, it's loaded. So you can see the default scheme is already loaded here and the master theme.